In this video, I will show you how to turn this cube into a camper interior that we can use later in animation like this one. There are a million of 3D models available for download online. But if you are looking for something specific, like the interior of 1986 camper used in the Breaking Bad series, you won't find anything. That's why it's good to know how to model. To know what we want to achieve, we need reference images. In my case, mostly screenshots from several YouTube videos. Modeling starts with some of the primitive shapes offered by Blender that best suit the object we are modeling. In this case, with a cube. In object mode, we can change the transform data such as location, rotation, scale, but we cannot change the mesh. We can change the mesh in edit mode with modeling tools. When we go to edit mode, we can see a lot more options than in object mode, but searching for tools in menu is not a practical. The modeling process is much faster if you use the shortcut keys. You can find lists of shortcuts on the internet, but my suggestion is to watch as many tutorials as possible, and over time more and more shortcuts will stick in your head. So let's start with some. With Ctrl R, we add loop cuts. How many loop cuts we want, we control with the mouse scroll. S is for scale. In this case, after S, I press X to scale only on X axis. G is for grab, Y to stick only on Y axis. In this case, move tool do the same. With Shift D, we can duplicate the face. SY to scale on Y axis, SX to scale on X axis, G to activate grab tool, X to stick on X axis, Y to stick on Y axis. E to extrude, 2 to switch to edge selection. With 1, 2 or 3, we jump between vertex, edge and face selection. Here I use G to grab, Y to stick on Y axis. S is for scale, but since I want to scale two faces at the same time, I don't want to scale them from a median point or bounding box, which is here, but from the individual origin of each face. So, in this case, the transform orientation is important. Now I can use S for scale and Alt T extrude along normals. By the way, if the extrusion go in the wrong direction, you can check the normal or face orientation in the overlays tab. Blender will extrude face in the direction the blue color is facing. If you need flip face, you can press F3 and search for flip. Loop cuts or Ctrl R is useful to create space or isolate a part. In this case, I isolate the part that I want to extrude later. Now I can extrude with E or Alt E, create a bevel with Ctrl B, and with I insert face. Tip: if you don't have enough space, with insert you will get a face overlap. To prevent this, you can use I slightly, after that S for scale. To select the entire loop, you need to hold Alt. To add more selections, you need to hold Shift. So Shift plus Alt plus click on edges. Now I can go with Ctrl B for bevel. This breakdown video is made from clips of a 4-hour long step-by-step tutorial in which we create these two Breaking Bad scenes, and of course model the camper interior. With one subscription on Patreon or by clicking on YouTube Join, you can unlock over 70 hours of tutorials and a large number of assets, including camper interior. If you are interested in modeling, several tutorials are just on that topic. But let's back to modeling. The shortcut for repeating the last action in Blender is Ctrl R. To convert a square object into a circle one, first we need more than 4 vertices. After that, you can use the shortcut Shift plus or plus S. Or simply install the loop tool extension and have this option on right click. Tip: to create a button, you can go with a new object. But if the face is not aligned with the world axis in Blender, aligning the button can be a pain. You can use snapping tool, but this is how I like to do this. I prefer to duplicate the existing face and use the normal face orientation. Now everything is perfectly aligned and I can extrude. More details always look better and more realistic. Although I can see the best what this radio looks like, I am adding as many details as possible. For the central instrument panel, I use same tools as before: bevel, insert, loop tool, extrude along normals, plus some selecting tools that I will mention later in the video. In this part, I create the most obvious details mainly using Ctrl-R for loop cuts, Ctrl-B for bevel, and I for insert. To add the bevel to the edges that we need, it is necessary to select the edges correctly and as quickly as possible. There are very useful selection tools. There are a lot of shortcuts for selection, and I could make a separate video about it, but these are the most useful for me. With holding Shift, the selection is added one by one. The whole loop can be selected with holding Alt. If we hold Shift and Alt at the same time, we can add selection or select multiple loops. With holding Ctrl, we can select the shortest path between two edges or faces. If we want to move to another part of the object, it is necessary to hold Shift, then we can continue with Ctrl. Keep in mind that this all works for face selection as well. A very useful selection shortcut that we didn't mention is L for selecting loose parts. Loose parts are all parts of the object that were created by adding a new object or duplicating a part of existing object in edit mode. Now we can just place mouse over that object and press L. The entire speed-up process you are watching is created with the shortcuts I mentioned earlier in the video. The shortcut to expand the selection is numpad plus, numpad minus takes away the selection. A Boolean modifier works by using one object to make a hole in another. In this example, the Boolean tool is useful to make holes in the mesh. Another way to create a hole is to select one vertex, go with Ctrl plus Shift plus B, which is a shortcut to bevel one vertex, then hold P to change profile. Now we can extrude, insert or whatever you want, and we have a hole for a glass or bottle. Keep in mind that Ctrl-R only works if we have four vertices. If we have an N-gon, you can always use K, which is a shortcut for the knife tool. After K, you can again use Y to stick to Y axis, X to X axis, Z to Z axis. For the steering wheel, I first modeled the basic shape using cylinder. After that, I used subdivision surface modifier to smooth everything out. Since I know it will be barely visible in the render, I don't care too much about details. The basic shape of the seat was built from cubes. After that, I smoothed the edges with Ctrl-B. For imperfections, I use displacement modifier with cloud texture. For the displace modifier, I need more mesh first, later I add subdivision surface also. To add more detail, I selected the edges, converted them to a curve. I selected the edges with Alt plus Shift. Alt select the loop and Shift add the selection. Now I can add thickness to the curve and we have seams. To get more details and avoid too much modeling, I use the PhotoScan object. With K, which is a shortcut for the knife, I cut out the parts that fit well. If the camera were closer to the object, I would probably have modeled more detail, but this looks good in the final render and saves time. In this case, I like to change the viewport display color to make alignment easier. That's all for this video. If you are interested in texturing and other parts of tutorial, look for it on Patreon, YouTube join link, Blender Market or Udemy. If you are interested in more about my Breaking Bad project, check out my previous video. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.